गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माय नेम इज दिलकर श्रीनिवास, NPHS तिरुमलगिरी, मंडल तिरुमलगिरी, डिस्ट्रिक्ट सूर्यापेट. नाउ फ्रॉम अवर प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी आर लर्निंग अबाउट द एक्सक्रीशन, द ऑर्गन्स ऑफ एक्सक्रीशन. It means the excretory organs and the structure of kidneys and how the excretion process was taken by the kidneys. And now today we are going to discuss the accessory excretory organs. It means some more organs also present in our body which play a role in excretion process. So these organs are called accessory excretory organs. Okay, let us discuss what are the accessory excretory organs. Means other organs also present in the body, they are called accessory excretory organs. How they are perform the process of excretion, let us discuss today. Okay, right, the topic, today's topic is other pathways of excretion. It means excretory organs. Okay, before going to discuss this lesson, just to think and give reflections to the questions here which are appeared on the screen. What happens if the animals cannot excrete? What happens if the animals excrete? And next one, are there any organs body perform excretion except the kidneys? Next, why our sweat is, whenever you taste your sweat, when we taste our sweat, it is just a little bit of a salty in taste. Why? Where the RBC is destroyed after its lifespan. You know RBC, red blood cells, that is discuss later. What happens if some of the excretory organs are not working properly? What happens some of the excretory organs are not working properly? These are the questions we have to discuss in this topic before. Okay, my dear students, let us go to next slide. Here in the lesson, today's lesson, the learning outcomes. The learner explain the process of excretion. The learner can prepare a model of large intestine. And the learner can give reasons why sweat and tears are salty in the taste. And the learner differentiate the skin and kidneys towards their functions. The learner can draw the diagram of various organs which perform excretion process. These are the learning outcomes in our topic. Okay, first of all, we have to recall again, what is excretion? Here, excretion means the elimination of nitrogenous waste materials or the elimination of nitrogenous harmful substances from the body is called excretion. We already discussed from our previous classes. Excretion means elimination, means removing out from the body. Which are eliminating here? The nitrogenous waste material or harmful substances which are formed in the body due to the metabolic activities, they should eliminate from the body. Enter this process means the elimination of nitrogenous waste material, it means nitrogenous harmful substances from the body is called excretion. You know, every living organism, the main aim of living thing is to survive in the nature. The living thing, if it wanted to survive, it need some energy. Okay, to get energy, it should perform some metabolic activities. This is a sequential process. During these metabolic activities, either it is so many metabolic activities are there in the body. During these metabolic activities, for example, heart pumping or cellular respiration, whatever it is. These are all metabolic activities. During these metabolic activities, so many waste materials are produced. These waste materials are accumulated in the body. If we cannot send out these waste materials from the body, they cause harm to the body. That's why every living organism should send out all these waste material. That is nothing but elimination of waste materials. This is this process is called the excretion process. Okay, let us study in detail during metabolic activities. What are the materials are produced during the metabolic activities? The waste products including carbon dioxide. You know very well this one. The waste product, that may be the carbon dioxide, or maybe the excess amount of water also produced during the metabolic activities. This excess amount of water and nitrogen compounds also produced during the metabolites. These nitrogen compounds like ammonia, urea, uric acid, and some bile pigments also produced during the metabolic activities. You know, these bile pigments are produced from the liver, from one organ. All these material substances are waste material, excess material. If we can't send out these excess material, waste material from the body, they cause harm. That's why the waste material or the excess material should be eliminated from the body. That's phenomena or that process is called excretion. You know very well about this excretion process. Here we know the kidneys are the chief excretory organs in the body. Which is the chief excretory organ? It means it is the major excretory organ. Which is the major excretory organ? The kidney is the major excretory organ, because kidney filter the blood and form urine, and in that urine so many nitrogenous materials are filtered during the excretion process, during the filtration process. You know already the structure of kidney. You know, you learned already the structure of kidney, how the urine formation taking place in the kidney. You know, the nephrons is considered as the structural and functional unit of the kidney. How the nephrons will filter the blood and form the urine, you already discussed about things. So here, the kidneys are referred as the chief excretory organs. It means chief excretory organs, major excretory organs, they are called kidneys. Okay, let us see once again how it is, you know, the kidneys are bean shaped and they contain so many parts. Here the cortex is there and medulla is there, and a renal artery is there which supplies the blood to the kidney, and renal vein which collects the blood from the kidney, and ureter is there. Ureter is the one of the pipe like structure which collects the urine, primary urine, from the kidney and transport to the bladder. And the kidney made up of millions of the microscopic structures. The structures are nephrons. You already studied this one. These nephrons considered as the structural and functional unit of the kidney. Okay, here next, how the nephron is structurized here. You know, there are two parts present in the nephron. One is Bowman's capsule and the renal tubule. This pipe-like structure, this is enter this part is called renal tubule. And Bowman's capsule contain again the glomerulus. It means the bunch of blood vessels. And the cup-shaped part is Bowman's capsule. And this pipe-like structure is a renal tubule. And the renal tubule contain again three parts. PCT, proximal convoluted tubule. And the DCT, distal convoluted tubule. And the U-shaped part is here. This U-shaped part is the loop of Henle. And finally, the filtration, the primary urine filtered by the Bowman's capsule, it moves towards the loop of Henle from the PCT and goes towards the distal convoluted tubule, and from that onwards, it enters into the collecting duct. Okay, here from the collecting duct, it passes out through the in the form of urine. Okay, let us. Are there any other excretory organs are present in human body? We already discussed about kidney. It is also referred as the major excretory organ or the chief excretory organs in the body. Are there any other excretory organs in the body? If so, what are the other excretory organs present in the human body? Let us discuss about these organs. Here, one is lungs. You know very well about lungs. Next one is the skin. You know about skin. And third one is liver. This liver is also called an excretory organ. It performs excretion process. And finally, large intestine. You know very well about these things. You know, these are the accessory excretory organs. It means these are the main, these are not main organs. These are accessory organs. It means they perform excretion besides its major function. For example, lungs perform respiration process. Even though the major function of lungs is respiration, but it is also involved in excretion. That's why they are called accessory excretory organs or secondary excretory organs. Okay, let us study in detail about all these organs in this chapter. Okay, lungs, you know very well. These are lungs. Lungs are made up of the sponge-like tissue. And the respiratory tract is there. Nasal cavities, nostrils, nasal cavities, internal layers, pharynx, larynx, trachea, bronchi, bronchioles, and finally lungs. These lungs are made up of a small part, a smallest sac-like structure. They are called alveoli. These alveoli are made up of a smallest tissue. These are the smallest sac-like structures. Alveoli are called the structural and functional unit of the kidneys. And how they are eliminate the carbon dioxide material, carbon dioxide. You know, during the respiration process, the air enters to the lungs and diffuses to the blood. And during the respiration process, the blood carries the oxygen molecule to the cells. And there in the cellular level, the respiration process taken place and oxygen is utilized in the cellular level and carbon dioxide released. That carbon dioxide is a harmful substance, useless substance, waste material. This waste material should eliminate from the body. If this carbon dioxide is stored in the cellular level, it interrupts, it disturbs other functions of the cells. That's why this carbon dioxide should eliminate from the body. That's why the carbon dioxide again transported back to the lungs and excreted or eliminated from the body through the lungs in the respiratory tract. So carbon dioxide, lungs perform respiration process. They are the major organs to perform respiration process. Even though they eliminate carbon dioxide, and also lungs perform elimination process of water in the form of water vapor. Okay, that's why lungs are called accessory excretory organs. They excrete or they eliminate carbon dioxide and water in the form of water vapor. And the next one, that is skin. You know, the skin is the largest organ in the body. Which is the largest organ in the body? The skin is the largest organ in the body. It covers all the body parts. Just imagine, if there is no skin around the body, what happens? Just imagine. Skin consists of a large number of sweat glands. Here you can see the structure of skin. It consists of a large number of sweat glands richly supplied with the blood capillaries. They extract sweat and some metabolic waste from the blood. Skin supplied a large number of sweat glands. Here you can see the sweat glands here, sweat glands are present here. And here sebaceous glands also present here. And melanocyte cells also present in the skin. Skin basically divided into two parts, epidermis, the outermost layer, and dermis, the inner layer. And below the inner layer, here is a fatty tissue. And so many blood vessels are present in the skin. And hair follicles also present in the skin. You know how the hair is originated? From the hair follicle of the skin. Hair is originated and sebaceous glands is a particular glands are present in the skin which secrete one kind of material that is sebum, and sweat glands are also present in the blood body. It in the skin it excrete the sweat, and melanocyte cells also present which secrete melanin which brings the dark color to the body. Okay, these are the major components in the skin. Okay, let us see the sweat gland secrete so many salts. The skin excrete plenty of water and a small amount of salts in the form of sweat, and sebaceous glands in the skin eliminate sebum which contain waxes, sterols, fatty acid and hydrocarbons. You know, during the summer season, after sweating, after a long large amount of sweat, what happened? Our face or our skin became oily due to the presence of sebum. Sebum contains wax like material, oil like material. That's why it look like oily. So how it happens due to the presence of sebaceous glands, due to the presence of sebum. Okay, sebum keeps the skin moisture, and also sweat keep the skin moisture. And here people in cold areas or cold countries get a very less sweat. Ever you notice this one? During the winter season also, we also in our area also, during the winter season we sweat feel a less sweat. Why? What changes occur in their skin and in other excretory organ during this season? During the summer season, we can feel a large amount of sweat. During the winter season, we can't feel so. Okay, that's why skin is also one of the excretory organ which secrete the excess amount of water, excess amount of salts and waste materials like sebum. And another part is there, that is liver. The liver is also considered as the accessory excretory organ. Liver, you know, the largest gland in the body, that is the liver. The largest organ in the body is skin. The largest gland in the body is liver. It produces bile pigments. It means bilirubin, bilirubin and urochrome. These are all called bile pigments. It means they produce, liver produce bile juice, and the bile juice contains this type of bile pigments. These bile pigments are metabolic waste of hemoglobin of dead RBCs. How these bile pigments are originated in the liver? It means the metabolic waste of hemoglobin of RBC. You know the RBC? RBC is the abbreviation of red blood corpuscles or red blood cells. You know the function of red blood cells here? You know the function of red blood cells? RBC is present in blood, and the major function of RBC is to transport the oxygen molecules by containing of hemoglobin. You know the lifespan of RBC is about only 120 days. After completion of its lifespan, they sent it to, they travel to liver and destroyed there. Due to the destroy of or decay of RBC and hemoglobin, the bile pigments are produced. And here, the urochrome is sent out from the body in the form of urine. Urochrome is mixed in the urine and sent out from the body. You know, the urine is also present. We can see the urine in amber color due to the presence of urochrome. You already studied this one. The urine is in amber color due to the presence of urochrome. Urochrome is nothing but one of the waste product which is generated by the liver due to the decay of hemoglobin. And bilirubin, bilirubin, these are the bile pigments are sent out through the phases matter. Okay, here bilirubin and bilirubin are excreted through the bile along with the cholesterol and the derivatives of steroid hormones, extra drug, vitamins and alkaline salt. And the liver is also involved in urea formation. This is one of the major function of liver. It is also involved in formation of urea. And another one, another organ is there, that is the large intestine. You know very well the digestive system. It is the digestive system. Here, this is the esophagus, the mouth, the buccal cavity, pharynx, and the esophagus, and the stomach, small intestine, large intestine, rectum, and anus. These are the components in the digestive system. Here, the large intestine also one of the accessory excretory organ, which eliminate the excess salts of calcium, magnesium, and iron. These excess salts are eliminated through the large intestine in the form of feces matter. Okay, these are the major, these are the accessory excretory organ. And here, small amount of nitrogen waste are also eliminated through the saliva and tears. Ever you taste the taste of tears, they are in salty taste. So saliva and tears also eliminate some nitrogen waste material, little amount. Okay, here is a table, just observe the screen. Name of the organ and excretory substance. Lungs excretes carbon dioxide and water. Liver excretes bile pigments, bilirubin, bilirubin, and urochrome. Large intestine, excess salts of calcium, magnesium, and iron in the form of feces matter, in the form of stool. And skin, it excretes sweat, sebum, and water, and other salts. Okay, this is the table which indicates the accessory excretory organ and the excretory substance. So here, the kidneys are called the major excretory organs, and these four, lungs, liver, large intestine, and skin, are called accessory excretory organs. Okay, let us recall, my dear students. Here, elimination of nitrogen waste material from the body is called excretion. The kidneys are the chief excretory organs in the body. In the respiration process, lungs remove carbon dioxide and water. It consists of a large number of, the skin consists of a large number of sweat glands richly supplied with the blood capillaries. And they extract sweat and some metabolic wastes. And here skin sends out plenty of water and small amount of salts in the form of sweat. Sebaceous glands in the skin eliminate sebum. And the next one, it produces bile pigments. Liver produces bile pigments, which are metabolic waste of hemoglobin of dead RBC. And excess salts of calcium, magnesium, and iron are excreted by the colon along with the feces matter. These are the main concept of this today's lesson. And small amount of nitrogen waste are also eliminated through the saliva and tears. And this is the time of evolution, my dear students. I hope that you understood the lesson, and go to evolution. What happens if the animals cannot excrete? What are the organs in the body perform excretion? What are the reasons of sweat and tears are salty in taste? You know, once again, what are the reasons of sweat and tears are salty in taste? Prepare a model of large intestine. People in cold areas get very less sweat. Why? Next, here some fill in the blanks are there. Amber color to the urine due to the presence of A, urochrome, B, bilirubin, C, bilirubin, D, chlorides. Here, due to the presence of urochrome, the urine appear in amber color. The A is the right answer. And second one, sebaceous glands in the skin eliminate urochrome, A. B is sebum, C, urea, this set, sebaceous glands secrete sebum, the eyelid, a wax-like substance. And which are the metabolic waste of dead RBCs? Bilirubin and bilirubin, B, hemoglobin, C, urochrome, D, bilirubin, bilirubin and urochrome. So D is the right answer. Bilirubin, bilirubin or bile pigments are the waste or metabolic waste of the dead RBCs in the body. Okay, thank you students. I hope that you understood the lesson, and we will come back again with our next topic with another lesson. Thanks for watching. Thank you. Myself, Jalakara Srinivas, School of Bioscience, and thanks for listening. Thanks to my technical team to support me, and thanks to other friends and colleagues to supporting this lesson. Thank you very much.